Gal Dixie here. Over the years, I've received several questions about cowboy camping. Some folks asking, how do you deal with bugs and other pests? And then in general, just how to go about cowboy camping. And one I received recently reminded me that I still haven't done a video about cowboy camping. So that's what I want to talk to y'all about today. For those of y'all who are not familiar with the term cowboy camping, it's basically just like in the old westerns, you know, when you see Clint Eastwood laid out looking all majestic under the stars, or John Wayne, whatever your preference is. I think Clint Eastwood's cooler. But anyway, it's just the idea of having no shelter and laying down on your sleeping pad, having your sleeping bag or quilt, and only having a blanket of stars above you. Now, while it sounds all romantic while you're watching a western or reading a Louis L'Amour book, there are some cons or downsides potentially to cowboy camping. One of the reasons folks are worried about cowboy camping is because of bugs. So there are some ways that you could deal with this if you do choose to cowboy camp. One way is to wait until you have cooler temperatures so there aren't as many bugs out and active. Also, you can avoid camping next to water sources, especially stagnant ones like ponds and marshy areas. That's because those are typically a breeding ground for our flying mosquito friends. And I mean, even if you're sleeping in a shelter, in my opinion, it's best to avoid camping in those areas. If you do decide to cowboy camp in an area where bugs are active, you can have your clothing and gear treated with permethrin. That will help repel and even kill some of the creepy crawlies that might come visit you at night. But again, it's only for your sleeping bag and clothing. It is not to be applied directly to the skin. Also, if you're bundled up at night, if you've got some long sleeve clothing on and you zip up your sleeping bag, so again, it's probably gonna be cooler temperatures for this to be comfortable, then the only thing that they can really get to as far as mosquitoes go is your face. So if you've got a bug net on, I never could get comfortable with one of those. I didn't try a whole lot. I kind of put it on, felt claustrophobic, and said I'll probably never use one of these. But if you're somebody that doesn't get the claustrophobic feeling of wearing a bug net around your head, then you can do that and still enjoy cowboy camping even while it's a little buggy out. And finally, you could do a bug net type bivy. I don't know, some people might argue that this isn't actually cowboy camping, but it's whatever, it doesn't matter. If you decide to go with the bug net bivy, then you might enjoy some of the benefits of cowboy camping while still protecting your whole body from the bugs. And then you can always use a tarp as your main shelter if you need one for the weather. And on that note, unexpected weather could also be a potentially negative aspect of cowboy camping and is something that I feel like prevents people from cowboy camping. But you can kind of plan for that. Already have your shelter pulled out, maybe not pulled out of the stuff sack, but pulled out of your pack and just right near you, just in case you wake up and it's pouring down rain or starting to sprinkle and you need to get things set up in the middle of the night. Obviously, it will help if you're already proficient at setting up your shelter. It's not something that's new that you got to try to figure out while, you know, you're in a sleepy stupor. So if you're already good at it, then it shouldn't take you long to do, even in the dark with a headlamp. I also suggest having a dry bag nearby. That way you can grab anything that you don't want getting wet and cram it in there while you set up your shelter. This actually happened to me and Aaron while we were camping together on the CDT. My weather app didn't show any sort of chance of rain, and the sky also didn't indicate that, but sure enough, around 3 or so in the morning, we felt some sprinkles coming down and it got heavier and heavier, but we were able to get our shelter set up before we got soaked. One of the things that I was concerned about when I first started cowboy camping was wildlife. For some reason, having a tent gave me this false sense of security, and I think a lot of people can probably relate to that, because a bear is not really gonna be stopped by Cuban fiber or silk nylon, you know, so if they really want you, they're gonna come in anyway and get you. But there's something about having walls and kind of separating yourself from nature that mentally makes you feel a little more protected. So this is something that I feel like is a little bit more of a mental hurdle than actually something to be concerned with. Now, there are deer and other critters that do like salty gear and will probably be a little bit more curious if all of your things are scattered about. But all in all, I really haven't had any issues with wildlife creating problems with me while cowboy camping. One of the things that you can do to mitigate this risk, though, is make sure that you're not on a beaten path that animals use. So no pathway down to a water source or, you know, any kind of clearing that looks like it would be easy for animals to get through, because they're going to use the path of least resistance just like us humans do. So also not camping on the trail that you're hiking on will help, because when you do have that shelter, it is more noticeable to critters and people than if you are just, you know, in a little cocoon on the ground. So you want to make sure that you're wise and pay attention to where wildlife might want to move when you set up your camp. And you could always do something like stab your trekking poles in the ground, and if it's not windy, then hang up a raincoat or something like that on your trekking poles, just to kind of give a little bit more indication that, hey, something is here. In addition to regular wildlife, there are a lot of people who fear that while they're cowboy camping, snakes will come cuddle up with them to keep warm. And I can't tell you that it's impossible for this to happen, because that's certainly not true. I don't know of anybody who has cowboy camped and had this happen, so I will say that I feel like it's pretty unlikely. Also, I guess just in thinking about it myself, when the nights are cooler, I always try to tell myself, well, by the time it's dark, if I was a snake and I was trying to get out of the cool weather, then hopefully I've already slithered off and found somewhere to keep warm for the night. So, you know, maybe they're not out searching at that time. Now, whether that's scientifically true and makes sense or not, I don't know, but that's what I tell myself to just try to get over that mental hurdle of being worried then a snake's gonna come cuddle up with me at night. And anyway, if you think about your exes, I'm sure some of you have already cuddled with a snake at night. The only place that I have ever backpacked where I've decided that wildlife makes me too uncomfortable to cowboy camp is in grizzly country. And honestly, that's probably a really good idea, because I feel like grizzly bears can be somewhat unpredictable and can decide they're having a bad day and they just want to maul something for fun. So having a shelter like a tent set up, kind of warning a grizzly bear like, hey, you might not want to come over here because this doesn't look quite natural and what you're used to, then, you know, hopefully they'll just kind of go the other way instead of coming to inspect the little lump on the ground or accidentally stepping over you and then getting ticked off because, you know, you were a speed bump in their pathway. So in grizzly country, I would say, you know, dot your I's and cross your T's and do everything you can to be as safe as possible, including avoiding cowboy camping. One thing that I noticed about cowboy camping is I'm not as warm as I am when I'm in my tent. And that makes sense, because having that extra layer of your shelter helps keep the warmth in and helps keep you in your little warm bubble while you're sleeping at night. So me personally, I reserve cowboy camping for warmer nights, but for the folks who don't sleep as cold at night as I do, this might not be an issue for you. And finally, with cowboy camping, you're probably going to experience some dew on your sleeping bag or quilt when you wake up in the morning, and even it might have already formed in the middle of the night if you wake up. So of course, not sleeping by a body of water will probably make this situation a little bit better, but it is common to have dew on your bag. Chances are though, if you're cowboy camping, you're probably doing so on days where the weather is supposed to be good. So you can always hang up your bag in a bush in a little patch of sun while you're packing up in the morning, or even on lunch break during the day, you can find a sunny spot. And after just a couple of minutes, usually your bag's gonna be dry if it was damp, not soaked. So now that I've discouraged everybody who is on the fence about trying cowboy camping with all of the negative or potentially negative aspects, I want to tell you some benefits of cowboy camping now and why I enjoy it and why I think others do too. First of all, with cowboy camping, you're likely taking up less space with your camping arrangements than you would with your typical shelter. So you don't have to be limited to areas that require a certain area that is flat for your tent, or maybe you don't have to worry about finding the perfect trees if you're somebody who likes to hammock. And it might allow you to stay in some pretty cool areas that you wouldn't otherwise, like maybe a rocky area that would be difficult to set up your shelter otherwise, but has a really cool view. So there's more versatility with cowboy camping. There's certainly much less effort to making camp at night and packing everything up in the morning, because you're not having to take the time and effort to set up your shelter and then break it down the next day. With cowboy camping, you're gonna get the best views possible. I think camping in an area where you've got a 360 view is incredible. Also, there's something magical about laying down at night and looking at the stars while you're going to sleep. And then I tend to wake up several times in the night. That's just how I am. So there's something about being able to wake up and see the stars above me that's just comforting and also exciting. And especially on nights where there are meteor showers, instead of trying to hang out the vestibule of my tent, I've just found that cowboy camping is a great way to enjoy that, but also nap in between. I also feel like I'm more a part of nature instead of just something traveling through it. I don't know if that makes sense. Maybe some of y'all have experienced that too. If you're somebody who isn't always an early riser, but you wish that you were, then cowboy camping has helped me with that because I'm more aware of the sun rising in the morning, and something about that makes me just go ahead and wake up and start my day. For me, cowboy camping has been a confidence booster in my backpacking experience because there are some fears associated with that. And even if they're not full-blown fears for people, then it's a little uncomfortable. Well, I feel like for most people anyway, when they first start cowboy camping and never have before. But that's something I've talked about a lot. When you're stepping outside of your comfort zone, then you're probably improving your confidence. So how exactly does one go about cowboy camping? Well, first of all, I highly recommend having some sort of ground cloth or ground sheet. So something like Tyvek or Polycryo, that's more lightweight than Tyvek. And Gossamer Gear actually sells sheets of this conveniently sized. They've got medium and large. So you're looking at somewhere between 1.6 ounces and 3.65 ounces, depending on the size of the sheet that you want. But just having something kind of lightweight to protect your sleeping pad, especially if it's inflatable from little things that could deflate it in the night, is a good idea. Now, if you have a footprint for your tent, you could just cowboy camp on that. For me, in using the duplex, it doesn't require a ground cloth because the Cuban fiber is durable enough to deal with being on the ground directly. So I didn't have a ground cloth. And what I started doing on the PCD was cowboy camping on top of my tent. So I would unpack it, but instead of going through the trouble of setting it up, I would just put my sleeping pad right on top and sleep on it. Now, I developed holes in that duplex, and one of the reasons could have been from the abrasion of having my sleeping pad on the thinner Cuban fiber that was the walls of the tent. It also could have been a bad batch of Dyneema, and it also could have been because I didn't keep it in a stuff sack in my pack. I just kind of shoved it in there. So all of that could have attributed to it. So I would warn against doing that. Now, something that Aaron did on the CDT was he took his Solplex and he would open the door area, the zipper there, and then slide his sleeping pad on the floor of the tent and sleep just on that. So he had the body of the tent kind of on top of him. So that makes sense because he was sleeping directly on the floor of the tent anyway. Now, I do think that this could increase dampness and condensation on your sleeping bag. But again, if you're cowboy camping at a time when you're having good weather, then you're probably gonna have dew anyway, but you're also gonna have that good weather window to hang something up during the day to dry out. Another idea of something that you could use as a ground cloth that's pretty cheap, but not as durable, is one of those space blanket, emergency blanket type deals. I used one on the CDT a couple of times after I saw somebody else do it, and Aaron also tried this on the CDT. Again, it's not very durable. They're gonna tear up pretty quickly. But if you're somebody that's not going to cowboy camp often, but you want the option, and you don't wanna carry a heavy ground cloth, and you also don't need one for your particular shelter, then this is an idea of something you could throw in your pack. It doesn't weigh a ton, but just another idea that I have tried and seen other people use. After you have your ground cloth down, you're just gonna put your sleeping bag on top of it, get on the pad and shimmy in your sleeping bag or attach your quilt, whichever you choose to use, and then sleep. I like to have my gear there close to me so an animal doesn't run off with it because they think the salt is tasty, or again, just in case bad weather does roll in, then I've got it there close by to set everything up. As always with cowboy camping, you should choose your campsite wisely. You wanna avoid any sort of depression where if bad weather does roll in, water will collect, and obviously you're gonna set up your shelter if it starts raining, but you don't wanna be in an area where if you just set up your shelter in a sleepy stupor, you're now gonna be flooded because you're in a depression where water's gonna collect. Also, be mindful of widowmakers. That's what we call dead limbs in the tree that can fall in the night and take you out. However, sleeping under a tree, if you're concerned about bad weather rolling in, isn't a terrible idea because you're probably gonna feel a little of the sprinkling, but the leaves will probably do a good job of keeping some of that at bay while you can set up your shelter before it starts the full-on downpour. Sleeping near some sort of bush or other windbreak isn't a bad idea just in case it does get a little windy in the night. And as I mentioned before, you don't want to sleep on anything that looks like a path for humans or wildlife. So now, after hearing the benefits of cowboy camping and some ways to mitigate some of the potentially negative sides of cowboy camping, if you're still a little timid about giving it a try, you could always ease into it by sleeping just with your hammock and no rain fly, and that way you're able to look at the stars and enjoy the sky that way. Or if you're a tenter like me and you've got a tent that's got its own separate rain fly, you can try sleeping with the rain fly off for a night. So once again, you don't have that full-on false sense of security that separates you from the rest of nature, and you can enjoy the stars, but you still have a little bit of comfort in knowing that your tent's already set up and you can just throw the rain fly on if weather does roll in. For those of y'all who already enjoy cowboy camping, what do you like about it, and what ways have you found to combat the cons? If you don't mind, leave that in the comments below, because I think it could help some folks who are on the fence about trying it. Go ahead and get out there and give it a shot. And that is all I have for y'all today. If you enjoyed this video or found it useful, don't forget to subscribe before you go. Thank you for watching, and we will see y'all next time.